So Rich has asked me to present to you the work of the Ecologically Sound Practices Partnership. I'm going to give you the briefest summary of that. It's all about delivering MWPA's work in an ecologically sound manner, and it recognizes that fire crisis and the biodiversity issues we have are largely driven by climate change. Almost all of these historic photos that we can see, these grasslands now have houses on them. They have a forest canopy of combination of native trees and planted trees, and then there's gardens underneath them. And unfortunately, most of those landscapes are unmanaged. So the goal for ESP was, for the Defensible Space Group, was how can we transform our properties into fire-safe, water-wise, biodiverse, and climate-friendly landscapes? I just want to say we have an opportunity to transform our yards, build more fire-smart, biodiverse neighborhoods, and then connect them across the landscape to address our wildfire, our climate, and our biodiversity crisis. So how do we do that? I say native plants are our best bets.
My name is Nate Clark. I'm the Biodiversity and Fields Management Coordinator for Marin County Parks and Open Space. I work with a group of people on our staff, and we handle a lot of the wildlife compliance that goes on with our projects in Marin County Parks and Open Space. And a big part of that environmental compliance is conducting nesting bird surveys prior to any vegetation removal work. So this is just a little chart that we have. It's kind of a timing of breeding season for birds in the North Bay region. It was put together by the Point Reyes Bird Observatory, which is now called Point Blue. As you can see, a lot of the egg laying kind of happens, starts to pick up in March and April, and then the young kind of flushes after this in this sort of second histogram here. And typically by about July, things have mostly tapered off in most species. Our own policy for parks is that once August 1st hits, we're able to do work without conducting bird surveys ahead of time. Kind of our general workflow, and I've adapted this a little bit to private yards, but first and foremost is you want to identify what vegetation you want to cut. Mike was talking about before, we don't necessarily advocate for cutting down all the trees, and maybe it's just a certain hedge where you're removing juniper or you want to kind of push back some of the lower branches on the ground. So first identify the project area, the vegetation, and then figure out when you want to do it.
But what I'm going to talk about is wildfire mitigation specialists that I have here in Novato. So we have 5 full-time specialists that go and give home assessments, and we help people understand how to have and improve their environment around their home, a home hardening, and their vegetation management. But as Nate said, it's important before you schedule any work to go around and do your own personal survey. He works mainly out in the open space, but that it's important that you take a good look at your property and you make some good sound choices to improve your defensible space. We want you to plant things that encourage the birds and the bees and the butterflies and all of those, because that's going to just improve our environment.